Hello, everybody. Hello, 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 hello. Sparrow Black, Sterlingdon, Coates, Dana Jessica Booth, Rooks, Sterlingdon, Dana Jessica Booth. You're all here. All the guys, all the gang, all the crew. How are you doing? Nice to see you. So we're here again. We're back. I'm still playing Elite Dangerous, of course. And making my way in the journey home, we have, of course, the spreadsheet of Destiny ready to go for the biscuit tasting experience at the end of the live stream for the last 10 minutes. I'm still gathering Jumponium, but listen to this, guys. Listen. I don't think you can hear a squeaky thing, can you? That's because I've upgraded the controller. Yeah, there you go. So let's still keep looking for some Jumponium, because if you are just joining us for the first ever time, which I don't think you are at this point, I think you all know what's going on. I am looking for stuff to get home, to make my way back to the wherever I'm going. Sol, that's the one. 1 second, screen capture. I'm just gonna grab this and make it big again. So as we can see, this is the route that I'm eventually gonna be taking over here. So I'm looking for, as you can see, that on the vanadium side of things, I don't know if you can see my my mouse here, but vanadium, I'm looking for 18 and 9 germanium. I think I already have that, but I'm going to just double check and get a couple more things first before I start jumping. But I think tomorrow will be the day that we finally start making our way back home to Sol, all the way from the other side of the galaxy. So I have, let's have a look. 18 and 14 germanium. So we need, well, I mean, according to the spreadsheet, that was the one-way requirement. So that means I can make it back as well, according to this spreadsheet. I think I had a bit more than that on the way in. So I'm still quite nervous. I'm gonna get some more of the larger things first before we leave. So just spend a little bit more time getting that last little bit. Hey, Griefed. Hello, everybody. Thank you very much. All the cool kids are here. You know it. I know why you're here, really. It's for the Excel spreadsheets. And for the, of course, exciting biscuit eating at the end. Yesterday, we sampled the wonders of the Jammy Dodger, but it didn't quite live up to the Butter Crinkle Crunch, which is currently sitting at the top of the leaderboard for biscuit delightfulness. There was a lot of work behind the spreadsheet. That spreadsheet previously wasn't by me. That was made by somebody else for me on the way in. Very, very kindly, one of the prospectors from the Rock Rats made it. But yeah, if you are just joining, this is the first time you're seeing this stupid stream. This is, I'm going to be playing it anyway at lunch times, because I was going to be jumping home, all the way home, back to Sol, to exchange my data in, because I've made it all the way across from Beagle Point, all the way to Beagle Point from Sol, as you can see. Here. I'm still all the way out there, 65,000 light years away. That's where I'm going. This is where I'm going to head to. So eventually you'll be joining me for these delightful fun time jumps. But for now, I'm just getting a little few more resources to make sure that I've got what I need. Grayson B is online again. I don't know if he's in the chat. Yeah, you do need jump range booster stuff to get there. At least I did anyway. And I probably have enough to get back now, but I'm being overly cautious because I really don't want to get stuck out there like an absolute chump. But how is everybody? How are you? 9 minutes later, Stryker. What kind of viewer do you think you are? Who do you think you are, a Stryker? But the idea is that I'm just going to be doing this anyway, so I thought, why not stream it and get people to come along and watch as well? So if this is the first time coming, please do subscribe as well. Because, hey, why not? Somebody is making me some lovely art as well for my stream, which I think is absolutely awesome. So I can't wait to show off that to you guys. But let's build this a little bit. Let's have some fun with it. Join me and tell me some stories while I sit and go home. So did everyone have a nice day yesterday? What is everyone up to? What's everyone been up to? We don't need chromium, we don't need nickel. Those things can sod off, sod right off. Was Stroker, you're not an internet nobody. You're welcome here. We're all best friends here. Give a Stroker some love. Especially Pieppy, the wonderful Ambassador Pieppy. Is that how you pronounce your name, Pieppy? I was going to say, this stream service is like probably going to take like 40 hours for me to get home, like 40 hours of joints. That's like 40 lunch times. That's 40 biscuits that we'll have on record. However, it's taken me 3 episodes just to get enough vanadium to jump home. So let's see what happens. I should maybe trust that spreadsheet, perhaps. What do you think? Trust the spreadsheet and start jumping today? Whoa! I think it's time for some overly cautious repairs. Up. It's very important to keep look after yourself when you're out here in space on your own. Jump, says Commander Hatch. He means start the jumps home, doesn't he? That's what he means. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. It's King Day in the Netherlands. What is that? What do you do on King Day? Dangerous Kaboo, thanks for joining us, by the way. The notorious Dangerous Kaboo from our live streams where we do the CQC. So you must have been paying attention yesterday when I talked about this nonsense. And thank you for joining us. Thanks for coming along. This is very barren, this area. I'm not picking up any signals at all. Really like to start seeing some stuff. Otherwise, it's time to get out of here, I think. I also have this very useful thing here that can help me find. The resource that I need. Why can't I scroll? Ah, there you go. Oh no, that's the wrong one. Beagle point. K2, K3. So I'm tempted to get some more. But apparently I'm on here already. Vanadium and yttrium, but I don't need that. Nobody needs that. Ain't nobody need that stuff. right, okay. Max Ursa's here. Ayo. Hey up, Max, sir, how are you? How are you, lad? Even though you're from t'other side of Pennines, you're still a good lad from up north. Hope you're well. Celebrate the King's birthday and get drunk and play video games in general. I trust you, Mark, but I don't think that on King's Day, that is like a national thing that everybody does. White Rose is the best rose. Spread sheets with Ed. Thank you, Robbie Wan Kenobi. I like it. I'm into it. The spread sheets. Does anyone know if it's properly saying that I'm streaming Elite Dangerous? Like, is it actually doing it all proper and stuff for the Twitch? A Twitch reading it all right? A blue skill. I don't know if the drift is that powerful. I know that the drift is pretty powerful, but I don't think it's quite powerful enough. Ooh, fuel. We don't want that. We do not want that. Thank you. Sorted. We're picking up some stuff on the scanner now. That's good, because I'm going to check one last time for any more of this jump stuff that we need. Pleppy show is playing Stardew Valley. Well, I won't be surprised, because I have played a lot of that game, but I played 47 hours of that game, but I'm through it now. I've done it. I've got over that. I'm through to the other side of Stardew Valley. Back in Elite. I just needed a palate cleanser after making it all the way to Beagle Point. I was like, I need something just really simple, just farming. And it was nice. I enjoyed it. But no, to streaming Elite Dangerous, that is what I want. Yes, it is. Thank you. Hey, Rob. Good to see you back. I like this little community that we're building here. If it ever grows, I'll be sad. I think we need to keep it small. I think we need to alienate people and tell them to leave. If more people turn up, like, get out. Who are you? Are you welcome here? That's not true. Everybody's welcome in the Church of Biscuits, the Biscuit Church. Now that's a church that I would subscribe to. The Biscuit Church. Right, outcrop, come on. What have you got for me? Tasty treats. No tasty treats. No. Guys, what do you think at this point? So, look at my modules. Sorry, not my modules, my materials, my synthesis materials for the FSD injections, right? So I can do 4 big jumps, and I know that I need to do at least 1. I think it's 1, but if I use 2, let's work out what I've got here. So according to this spreadsheet that we have here, let me bring it up. According to this spreadsheet, have I just had this spreadsheet up on the screen for ages? Sorry. This is learning Twitch. That's what I want. It's just spreadsheet time. So I need to get rid of that, sorry. Here we go. This one, according to this one, there's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 jumps that I need Jumponium for. The biggest one is gonna be this one here that I think I needed the extra boost on it for. So that's gonna take up, only costs 1 to do them. It's only the cadmium and the niobium, really, that are causing the problems. And they take 2 and 1 for the vanadium. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So even, so should be all right. Should I be all right? Everyone, what do you think? Is it time to start jumping? Thoughts? Yeah, stop jumping. That could be it. Sterlingus is probably. If I get stuck though, it'd be right. Jump. It'd be right, mate. All right. There's been no better time than now. Seize the day. Frameshift drift all the way home. Hey, Andrea Kitty, hello, how are you? Nice to see you. Make like Van Halen and jump. Are you allowed to play songs on Twitch? Take your time. It will take me a long time to get back. But yeah, I'll be following that route, this one, very specifically back. So you'll see 27 is my first jump. And then you can burn off fuel as well, to make it easier to make the jump and stuff like that. But that's very nerve-wracking. Yeah, I should be okay. Yeah, and I'll still be able to collect materials if I need to as well. Rooks is right. Thanks, Grief. I like it. Yeah, you don't have to bush today. There's only 27 people watching, but it's my 27 of my favourite people in the world right here. So the VODs will be muted. Oh, that's weird. All right, has my ship arrived yet? I thought I'd wear a YouTube gaming t-shirt as well today while streaming on Twitch, because I'm that kind of rogue. That's rogue behaviour. All right. Oh, no green polo neck jumper. Right, that's it. You guys deserve the best. Give me a second. I'm gonna see it. It might not work. Give me a second. You guys deserve the best, and I'm gonna give you the best. Causing havoc. It might be a slightly different green. So look, Can you see? Yeah, it's gonna work. It's gonna work. It's a little bit insane, isn't it? Here we go. It's the green floating head. You've got a floating... I need to sort of pin it up here like this. Then the chair gives away the illusion of the floating head. Floating head. Floating head. So if this isn't going to get subscribers, then I don't know what is... I don't know what's happening. Hands. Ooh. There you go. Now we're talking. This is so silly. Sorry, I'm gonna take off the green thing. Let's go. We'll perfect that. We'll perfect that. That was very strange. Yeah, it was a bit odd, wasn't it? Sorry, Pleppy. I do apologise. It's the most excited the chat's been yet, though. But I know everyone's here for what they're here for, really. And that's I did a guess of that one, and that is for the biscuits. But we've got another half an hour. Ship under attack by me. Like an idiot, I pressed the wrong button. All right, we're here. We're gonna go. We're gonna start jumping. Oh. Did you see that on the screen? Oh yeah, very good. Turn off shields to save fuel. I am absolutely not turning off shields. Last time I did that, I took a lot of damage. Sorry, Andrea. I know what you're getting at, and it's. It's a good suggestion, but I'm just nervous about it. Get in. Get in. Oh, trolling ship. Troll. He's a little troll, this guy. Right. Get lost. I've had enough of you. We're going somewhere else. It's flatter ground over this way, it looks like. Yeah, it's this silly little trolling ship that I've got. Hey, Mad Dog! How are you? Thank you very much for joining us. Sending the ship away. I'm going to try and call it in here. It's happened to me the last 5 times I've landed on this planet's surface. So, that was the floating head bit. Hope you enjoyed the floating head bit. We'll have more from the floating head in future live streams. Don't just land in the same place again. If you've landed in the same place again, I know it looks pretty good. This looks pretty nice. He's done a good job. The floating head was pretty strange. Floating head. I mean, that's what I would, if I was doing it properly, if I was doing a Twitch stream properly, that's what I would do. I would do the floating head, and that would be my gimmick. I would just be a floating head on screen when I do all my reviews and stuff. But luckily for us, that isn't something I have to even think about. Why are you not? It's not quite close enough in. thought the floating head was good. Yesterday we had 45 people viewing. Got fewer numbers today, but the quality of people in the chat is higher. So, and that's all that matters, really, isn't it? It's as high, you know. Soon, when it's refining the audience, isn't it? That's what it's all about. You get 20 people in here, and they're all the best. Oh, just jump. Hey, Goxy79, thank you very much for joining us here. This is my live stream all about jumping all the way home from Beagle Point to Sol, which is 65,000 light years. It's on my lunch breaks. This is what I do. This is what I'm doing while everyone's munching away at their salads, whatever else they eat. I'm here doing this, and then in the last 10 minutes, we're going to do a biscuit review. I've got the spreadsheet ready to go. I know everyone's very excited to see how today's biscuit, by the way, spoilers for the biscuit part, is the rich tea. It was going to be a dark chocolate hobnob, but that's been pushed back for probably, maybe not even tomorrow, but maybe sometime next week. But today we've got the rich tea, a classic, a family staple, a family favourite, some might say. Right, let's do this. So as we can see on this route, the first one that I need to go to is, because I'm here currently, is this one, and it is 27.16 light years away. So let's see how that works out for me. So I can plot the route. Can I plot a route? Or will it not let me? No, route unavailable. That's because I need to upgrade my jump range. Now the question is here, it's 27.2. My current jump range is sitting at 26.3. So all I'm gonna need to do is a singular, gotta minimize that. All I've gotta do is a singular boost, right? Gonna give me all I need, yeah? Yeah? So here we go. First one. Basic frame shift. Ready? First jump in the massive jump home epic adventure that we're going on together. So here we go. Here we go. We're gonna work through the Hobnob family, I promise. Astroika, did you win the internet position rich tea? I mean, everyone loves a bit of rich tea. We haven't done Jaffa Cakes yet. It's an offshoot. We're gonna be debating together in the chat whether, so that's why you should keep coming back for these, because we're gonna be discussing all this. This is a journey that we're gonna go on together as a community. We're gonna debate together whether, I mean, the actual final scoring is kind of subjective. It's down to really me and my opinion. But we're gonna discuss together whether or not Jaffa Cakes and things like that and wagon wheels should be included. Well, we're gonna, so yeah, furry red tree, I'm off, I'm finally doing it. As you can see, this is where people are gonna start to see the problems with my ship. Let's get to know my ship, everybody. So what we have is we have a fuel scoop with a maximum fuel per second of 176, as you'll see right there. That is the maximum that I can scoop up. So I'm gonna keep things at about 3/4 because I don't wanna get too high for these larger jumps, just to make sure that I can do them. Some of them need a little bit extra, and the more fuel you got, mass, it slows you down, makes you heavier so you can't jump as fast, as far. If you look at my modules, you can see that I've got, I mean, 0% of my cargo hatch, 3% of my beam laser, like everything is absolutely destroyed. My FSD will fail every other jump. So we're gonna get to know the ship. You're gonna love the ship as much as I do. It is an absolute pain. I hate it. It's full of biscuit crumbs everywhere as well. That is also true, Pleppy, thank you very much. Ed scoops upside down. No, I scoop, and because I like to see that where the line is to make sure that I don't go under there. I've done a lot of crashing, as you can see my hull's at 70% into the stars on the way out here. The last 20 hours of jumping, I didn't make any mistakes. So I'm going to be concentrating a little bit on doing that. So let's do the second jump. This first sections of jumps are going to take quite a while to make it out there. Let's see, where's the next one? Going to, we are going to this one here with 33. So this is potentially the one that I'll need to do the double booster. Let's have a look. Let's have a look. So 33.4. Let's have a look. FSD boost, yes. Boost. So yeah, 32.54 as you can see. So I'm going to need to do my double boost. I think this is the one that I need to do the double on. We will see. Sorry, I didn't click on it like an idiot. Oh, which one was it again? Got to make sure, like, I'm being very, very careful with where I, with how I do this, because I will just get stuck. Sorry, fungus in. Okay, 4 available, and we've still got 8 available, so we should be able to make it out. I think. Here we go. Frame shift injection. Go. Yes, in the United Kingdom, having a tea without a biscuit is a criminal offence. That's true. It's fact. Obi-Wan Kenobi says, I don't understand biscuits from my point of view. So I think we're sort of talking about cookies, if you're American. America is all about the cookies. They call it cookies. That's kind of what we're doing. We're combining it. It's cookies. It's all of it together. Cookies, biscuits. They're all similar. Similar stuff. Similar fare. Let's see. Where are we up to now? I won't have to do this when we've got far enough out. I won't have to check this sort of stuff out. When we've got enough stars around. I'm just being careful because I don't want to get screwed over. So once I've made it to a certain point where there's lots of stars, I'm just going to be jumping as fast as I possibly can. Here we go. This one's nice and easy. Don't even need any tramponium for it. Gone. Onwards. Hey, Ozric42, thank you. He was late. He says he's late. He needed some fresh air, so we went for a walk in the snow. In the snow? Where are you? Mad. He's going for a walk in the snow. He said he's late. He just knows that the biscuit review's on its way in about 15 minutes time. And that's what he's here for. He skipped the opening boring bits. I understand. I know what's going on. Custard tarts. Sterlingdon asks Sterlingdon, what does everyone think? Custard tarts, biscuit, does it qualify for the biscuit reviews or not? Custard tart. It's snowing up north. The beautiful north. 27.92. I think that's just going to need a standard jump. There's some 30s down there, though, that I'm worried about. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six jumps, but I don't think that they're... Let's find out. Head away from that star. So it's 27.92 and I'm currently at 25 and I would need to even if I was low on fuel anyway, so let's do it. Basic, 7 injections remaining, 3 remaining of the big ones, but I think, let's have a look. My jump range is 32 with 1. That's the wrong thing, we don't want that. So my jump range is 32. So I've got 31.78, a 30, a 30, and a 32.19. So what was it again? 32.40. So I should be fine to make it home on those 7 jumps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. two, three, four, five, six, seven. And how many jumponiums did we say I had left? Six. Oh, not including the one I'm just about to do, right? Please say it's not including the one I'm about to do. Two, three, six. Yep, just the right amount. It was nerve-wracking there. I thought for a second I was doomed. I thought I was going to die in a hot, fiery sun. All right, let's do this. Next jump. Thanks very much for joining us, everybody. It's an absolute pleasure to have you here. What's everyone doing? Did we vote on... Oh, no. Yorkshire puddings? Are now people talking about Yorkshire puddings? What is happening? This is confectionery chat, although Yorkshire pudding is not a piece of confectionery. Yorkshire pudding, of course, is part of the Sunday roast, which is a very, very important British institution. It's where we eat a roast dinner. It's quite obvious what it is, really, isn't it? Let's be honest. You can do that as well, yes. That is when you fill the plate. You actually have it as a, yeah, it's amazing. It's basically baked pancake mix. That's a good point. Strong. Right, okay. This one is where we're going to next. That is 31 lighters away, so that's gonna take a FSD injection basic. I think. Yeah? Oh, hold on. Have I done it? Have I broken myself here? No, 32, that's fine. Okay, good. Whoa, oh, that was close. So, grief really is, I made the day on Monday with roast leftovers. Osric 42 says, Mad Dog, that sounds delightful. Toad in the Hole, yeah. What is Toad in the Hole? Everyone can clear that up if you want. He wants to clear Toad in the Hole. Tim Tams might be the best biscuit. Tim Tams, that sounds like something that I've got no idea what. What are Tim Tams? Someone explain Tim Tams to me. Vanny98 specifically. And if barely available in Scotland. We need to get some Tim Tams. It sounds like Tim Tams are important. They're like penguins. Okay. Do they count as a biscuit? Don't know if they do. Right, okay. Biscuit chat. I can't believe this has gone so in the biscuit direction. Next one. Okay, so we don't need... So we might be able to just go straight to here. Oh yeah! Now we're talking. Route available. And now the jumping starts. I've nearly made it. I've nearly made it out of the hell that is this Beagle Point. Finally making it out of there. Natalie and Brulia says there's something that's amazing you can do with penguins. All right. What's that then? Bite one corner off, bite the opposite corner, dunk one exposed corner in the tee, and suck through the other side like a straw. And when the tee hits your mouth, put the whole lot in and enjoy the chocolatey loveliness. That does sound really good. You can do the same thing with Kit Kats as well. Bite both ends off the Kit Kat and suck it through, and the wafer gets really soft on the inside. It's really, really good. Now, does Kit Kat count as a biscuit as well? Because Kit Kat's a little bit of an enigma. It's a chocolate bar. I do love a chocolate. Chocolate bars, are they biscuits? That's a good question. That might be for series two of The Journey Home, where we make our way back out. We do chocolate bars instead, or crisps. We can do all sorts of food reviews, and then everyone can see my waistline expand as we extravagantly make our way across the galaxy. But we're doing it. We're finally doing it. We're actually making those jumps home. So thank you so much for joining me on this adventure, everybody. It's going to be a bit more laid back. Just a lot of jumping, a lot of chatting. Taking it easy. Yawning. Lots of yawning. Pizza review, all right. Oh my god, I'd love some pizzas. If we could get like different pizzas in. My jump range decreases. Command Hatch, my jump range doesn't decrease, but my jump frequency decreases. Because I'm just like, I do not want to jump anymore. I have eaten far too much. Next. I'm not doing any scanning, but I don't need to because I've scanned these areas already. I know I have. I do scan. Hey, everybody! We need to turn this into a drinking game. Every time the FSD malfunctions, everyone has to take a shot of water, of course. It is 1 p.m. Unless you're watching this somewhere else. A striker, you don't play the game. Sorry, I didn't mean to look so offended by that. I'm sure you do. Oh, okay. A striker, explain the jumping. Sure. Okay, sorry. Sorry, okay, well, great. So, 8:42 in America. Don't do any shots in America, 8:42. Unless you've got nothing else in your life to look forward to, then maybe you should. No, don't do that. Never. So, what you should do, a striker, everybody, this is just one tiny aspect of what you can do in Elite Dangerous. Well, it's pretty massive, to be honest, is the exploring aspect of things. But yeah, I'm scooping from these stars. And as you can see, I'm all the way out in the galaxy. I'm absolutely miles out from Sol, which is ridiculously far. And you've just seen me do 6 jumps, okay? And it, for about 1,000 jumps for me in this jump range, in this ship, it takes me about 45 minutes to do 1,000 light years, and that's when I'm jumping quickly and efficiently. So 65,000 times 45 minutes. Sorry, 65 times 45 minutes is about as long as it's going to take us to get over here, all the way back there. We're going to stop off at the core for a picnic, where we have, where we're going to run through the top 10 and I'll start getting some guests on at lunch and stuff as well to chat with me while we do this. But I think it's mainly just my little stream that we're doing for fun. But Elite Dangerous is all about. There's so much more going on. You've got loads. We've got like. Bounty hunting, you can do missions, you can land on the planet surfaces if you've seen me driving around, you can go trading, you can go and be a pirate yourself, but that all happens all the way over there in the bubble, back in these areas, and you can actually see they've got a bit more sort of, they've got names and stuff over here, as you can see there, and that's because people and humans live there in stations. So yeah, you should definitely check it out, like seriously. Especially if you're an EVE fan, it's just another great space sim. Elite Dangerous is awesome. I've had some of the best gaming experiences of my life playing this game. And it's the community as well. I mean, look at these guys here chatting as well, like right now. Hey, Psycho Cow, how's it going? How's it going? How are you? But everybody else, what's your favorite thing? Write in one line what your favorite thing is about Elite Dangerous. And then people can help you out and let you know, like, genuinely. I do a lot of talking about Elite Dangerous, yeah. It's what I do. Almost for my job. It's my evening job after my day job. Wow, Psycho Kai, you took your word. That's amazing. That's so good to hear. Hope she's doing well. All right, let's do the next jump. Well, Archer, what is it about the community, though? Like, if you can sort of explain it. I just think it's because, like, they just come together in such really interesting ways, and like use what's available in Elite Dangerous, like the mechanics and stuff, and like sprinkle like just a tiny bit of imagination onto it, and manage to create things like the Fuel Rats and the Hutton Truckers, the Elite Racers, and all these guys do completely different things in the game. Sterling, I could do a Planet Coaster stream with the Empires. I'll eventually do a Planet Coaster stream. Yeah, that'll be fun. What time is it now? What time are we on? 45. All right. Well, about 5 minutes' time, we will start the biscuit reviews. I'm just going to check to see where we're up to in the galaxy while I refuel. Well, I'll finish that off first, and then I will jump to here. So just, in fact, there, which is just before my next Jumponium jump that I have to do. So let's see if we can navigate all the way to there first. Yes we can. That looks like a big jump, that last one. Let's go. So yeah, because I'm in an Asp Scout, which isn't actually a particularly amazing ship for jumping, the cannon, if you want something, to get their decals that they plan for almost a year now. That would be spoiling things if I was to tell you about decals, so that's not what we're here for. We're here for this jump. It's just crazy. There's the amount of stuff in there, like people are saying. I think that they do post some stuff in the forums, but if you were to mention that to them, or I can mention it to them to start posting in the forums for you if you want to race with those guys, because those guys are a lot of fun. Percat's in here. You don't use Discord either, Osric. Of course you don't. He uses Twitter. Deficit malfunction, everyone take a shot. Whee! Lads. Right, okay, this is craziness. All right, at my next refueling point, I'm going to send out a tweet saying that the biscuit eating is going to commence. And I want to, because I'm just wondering if that's going to give a boost to people actually coming into the chat. I think it'll be quite funny. Mumble. Stroika's mumbling. Stroika is, Discord's a pretty cool place. Like, it's very good. Like, we've got some Discord channels set up for the Galactic Academy and stuff like that as well. So you can go in there and learn anything you want to about Elite Dangerous. Do you know who I'm offended by, everybody? He was here on day one but hasn't returned since. Angerbeard and DJ Knight. And DJ Truthsayer as well, he was supposed to be here too. It's as if people have their lives that they have to live instead of watching me at lunchtime jump from star system to star system for endless hours. Look at that place. Look at that beautiful place. Oh yeah, I'm going to send that tweet, aren't I? Tweet time. Sending tweets on the phone. It's time for sending tweets. Here we go. Tweet time. Biscuit review starts in 1 minute. This is the live stream where man sends tweet. All right. No idea. There we go. So, Percat said you'll stream for lunch. Yeah, I... No. It's just my lunchtime. Like, I was going to be doing this anyway. Like I said, I'm jumping all the way back home, back to Sol. So I thought I would just stream it anyway. And people are turning up and coming to watch. And I think we're having a nice time. So I think we're going to carry on doing it. If people want to, I'm having fun. I have to like literally shovel my lunch down before I come on, like at 5:00. It's fine. It would actually work because the FSD drive fails like one every three. Sometimes it fails like four times in a row, though, so that would be bad. That'd be bad news. No, FDev have like a few. Like our lunch hours are quite strict, and most people like literally work through their lunch hours too. What did Grief do? Well, food and coffee. All right. Well, I think that's where we're at here, right? So I'm gonna park my ship up here, staring at the sun, at the star, whatever star is, beautiful. Hopefully we'll do some good discoveries as well on the way out. Find some interesting things in space. If anyone comes in now and grabs my controller and throws me into the star, I will be so disappointed because it's 70 hours, literally 70 hours of playing this game. But no one's going to come this far out. Although, and this is for a striker. Basically, if I was back closer into the bubble, I might get attacked here by pirates. I might get interdicted out of Super Cruise, which is not faster than light travel. Is it faster than light travel, Super Cruise? Yeah, it is. Of course it is. I will be pulled out there and I might be destroyed or killed, but this far out, it's going to be very, very rare chance that I'm actually bumping into any commanders out here. So yeah, I'm going to go and do the classic Lewis maneuver of going to grab a cup of tea because for the dunkability test, but we'll be back with the biscuit review in just about 2 minutes' time. Hello, everybody. I'm back. Your green screen, your coat's gone green screen a little bit. On the way in, I literally caught Chris Gregory here.
All right.
Director of art.
That's me. Yeah.
On Elite Dangerous, and he was just walking past, and I said, "Why don't you come and sit down and watch me review this biscuit?"
This is what you get up to at lunchtime.
This is literally what I got up to. So Perkart259, this guy is Chris Gregory. He's a regular. You've been on the podcast before, and stuff, haven't you?
A few live streams here and there when we've got some stuff to talk about. But
Were you looking for me to find to ask a real, genuine work related question?
I was wanting to inquire about some stuff that we won't talk about right now.
Well, it's too late. You're here now.
That's fine. Not a problem. Mm. So what biscuit are you reviewing today?
So episode 3.
Right.
Of the biscuit. I've done it starting on Monday. I'll show you. This is how much effort I've been putting into this. It's very silly. Here we go. So we'll add it for people at home. They can see it. There it is. Wonderful stuff. So there we are. So don't worry about Chris's green coat.
It's
the green. Yeah, it looks. That's how Chris shimmers in
it's
life, just like
1970s that. Doctor Who. It's good.
Yeah. So finally, someone's opinion on biscuits being respect and value. How dare you?
Ah, well.
You've got to respect my opinion. So as you can see, the Jammy Dodger was yesterday. Appearance. I go through each one. At the end, we have a score.
Okay.
And then eventually, on every live stream, we're going to eventually have a list of like 60 biscuits.
A totalizer.
With a ridiculous list of where you can see.
When's the bourbon coming?
I don't know when. People are sort of nominating them. It's basically whatever happens. So first of all, Chris, this is what we go for. We go for the, and we're only on for another 2 minutes. Don't worry, I'm not going to keep up too much of your valuable time.
Fair enough.
It's still the lunch hour, so it doesn't count.
Technically, yeah, it's fine.
Nobody knows we're doing this either. So first of all, Chris, what we do is we get only episode 3, and I've already got a guest.
Like
this. Look at this guy. Rich tea, here it is. Rich, that's a bit sort of white balance going on there. Sorry, Chris. As you can see, it says, one thing I like about the rich tea is that it says round biscuit.
Just in case you were wondering.
Yeah, you're like, I thought it was a square.
I think more biscuits should have this square biscuit.
It is not a chocolate hobnob. I'm sorry, Osrich. We will be doing the chocolate hobnob.
I'm just going to throw some options out there. Tunnock's tea cake. Surely. It's just going to win.
Is it a biscuit?
Have you never had a Tunnock's tea cake?
I've had one, but it's not a biscuit.
It's a biscuit. Some might say it's a wafer.
Okay, I invited him on for fun, and then look what happens.
I would argue it's a biscuit.
I like that Chris comes in and goes, is this what you do on your lunch breaks? It's like, yes, it is.
Didn't know.
So rich tea, it says round biscuit on it. Appearance, I like the indentated dots, but I find it's classic, but it's standard. You know, it's better than it's not as good as a Jammy Dodger in appearance, for example, because the Jammy Dodger looks amazing.
It's not as fancy, but I would say it's a reserved design classic.
It's better than the Fox's Butter Crunch, but it's not as good as Jammy Dodger, so I'm going to put it at a 6.
Six for me.
Is that
okay?
Taste. Here we go. So first bite. I've got to cover this.
I think you should hold the microphone closer as you're eating it. If anything, really get that crunch going in there.
Get that crunch.
Yeah.
At the end of the stream, when we do the biscuit things, more viewers come in. No one's interested in the bit where I jump home to Sol. Right. It's plain, but it's good. It's a traditional tasting biscuit, but it's a good tasting biscuit.
Goes well with a cup of tea.
Well, we're about to get onto dunkability in a minute.
Oh, interesting.
It's plain, but it's better. It's a 6. I mean, nothing. It's no better or worse than the previous ones.
Okay.
In my opinion.
Well, you know.
And I actually quite like the matte texture more than this is all too similar. Durability. So it's about how crummy it is, and actually that's really good. That's not a crummy biscuit.
That's left minimal residue.
It's minimal residue on there.
Say.
So it's going to be a 7. Mm. Or like an 8. Like an 8. Surprising. Surprising details. Surprising details, everybody. It takes timing to dunk a rich tea. So Sterling D, so be careful.
You don't want to lose it.
Did you know that Marvel Civil War started over the Jaffa cakes or biscuit or not debate?
team Jaffa or team...
team cake or team biscuit or team... So, dunkability, what I do is I hold it in for 3 seconds, then I pull it out, and then we see how much it's held up, and that'll be a 5 if it's held up,
okay.
And then we dunk it again for a double dunk, And if that falls apart, then it's between 5
is
and 10.
Is this why there's tea all over the desk?
Just covered
it's
everywhere.
It's a biscuit. It's really quite unpleasant in here.
Yeah, yeah. All right. right. Okay, okay. Are you ready? That's you can see some sagging.
It's a little bit of droop.
It's not going to be good for the. It's not going to be good for the double dunk. But it's good for that. 1, 2, 3. So we're talking straight in there. We're talking straight in. But it was about the same as. I gotta give it 8s for those. That's a high score. I'm gonna go for an 8 again.
Okay.
Because it wasn't perfect. Yeah, no one likes the double dunk. Okay, and here we go. So post-dunk taste. Now this, I know, is good. It is really good.
He's enjoying that.
As a strong... Yeah.
He's not acting that. He's really enjoying that.
Acting that. Oh, what's this number here? How did this sneak in? It's not organised at all. Sorry, guys. Post-dunk taste was strong. It was like an 8. Satisfaction overall.
You seem pretty satisfied.
No, it is good. It is really good.
I'd say it's a refreshing biscuit.
Mm.
If a biscuit can be refreshing, I would say.
It is. It's at least as high as a Fox's Butter Crunch.
It's invigorating.
Moorishness. I definitely can have more. I would go for an 8.
Okay.
Bringing Rich Tea into the lead.
Wow.
Total
that's
score.
Impressive.
Of, let's see, how do we do this? I can do that. Nope, wrong one. There we go. Bringing Rich Tea into the lead above Fox's Butter Crunch and Jammy Dodger in at the bottom. Top place, 57. Well, round of applause, everybody, for the classic Rich Tea biscuit.
I think that shows sometimes less is more.
I think so. Yeah. But wait, just wait. You wait until we get onto those ridiculous chocolatey cookies, because that's what I'm really into. So as soon as we get onto those and the tastes, the taste is like 10. I'm just like, boom!
Okay.
Explosions in the mouth.
Does this segment have a name? Is it like Take the Biscuit with Ed, or is it
Take
got
the
like
Biscuit?
A,
what's Take the Biscuit's good. It doesn't. What do you think it should be called?
I don't know. I think you should ask the folks watching, really.
What do you think? Everyone's got their money on a ginger nut.
Ginger nut, nice choice.
All right. Well, we've gone on too long. We're past lunch break now. We're actually being naughty at this point.
It's terrible.
So we should get back to making a game.
Got some engineers' bases to go and
Whoa,
make.
Whoa! Hello. Yeah. All right. And so everybody, thank you again. One thing I'm going to really, really quickly do is get rid of this. I'm going to go to the main menu and I'm going to quit out of here. We will be rejoining tomorrow for. We'll be returning back again tomorrow, same time, right about 1 p.m. for another biscuit review, and also continuing the journey home back to Seoul, which is very, very exciting. So thank you very much for joining us today. It's 1 p.m. till 2 p.m. BST. That's when my lunchtime is. So do come along tomorrow. Thank you again, and thank you, Chris, for joining us as a little special guest at the end. That
Pleasure.
Wasn't planned. He just literally came in
no
to find me.
No biscuit for me, though.
So. No, sorry. I would have brought 2 if I knew that. Right. Well, anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye-bye.